This is the second part of Peter Green's Merry-Go-Round. It's the singing part, the first singing chorus, with lead guitar parts filling in. It goes like this. Where I first met you, babe, you know I didn't even know your name. Yes, when I first met you, baby, you know I didn't even know your name. I was feeling so low on the ground. Bad luck and evil women, and what's to blame? Okie doke, so let's go through those phrases then. So the first thing that he does is he just plays an F9 chord. And then the first riff that he plays in that solo is this. So we're in the C shape here. Okay, and he's playing this note to start with. Nice and quick. Then he finishes that off with this note. So again, if you think about this shape here, like a C chord. So he's really playing it around there. So he's finishing on that C note here, an octave lower than this one. Okay, so he does a little bit more singing, then we get these chords. So all you've got there is an F9, an F sharp 9, back to an F9, then you get this next lead part. Do that again slowly. I'll just do it in parts. And then. That whole phrase. Okay, and then the next phrase is this. So really he's playing these notes, but he's using bends to make the sound. So he's starting off with a bend release, with a pull off, he's only picking that once, and then picking that little phrase once as well. So what he's doing there is he's picking it, pulling off, and then bending with the first finger from almost to that note. Okay, and then he sings, I was feeling so low on the ground. So he's sliding in. could do it with your third finger. Doesn't really matter. And then it's bad luck and evil women are what's to blame, and then he plays this riff. Do that again. So he starts off. Do that part again. Then this. So I think of that as being, it's one phrase, but I think of it as being two phrases really, split like this. That's one phrase, then. Okay, and then the last little phrase that he does is. So it's all on these notes, but using bends. And then the very last thing he does is. And then to bring it into the next section, he just does, which is a C6, sliding down two frets, which is essentially making a C9, because you've got the ninth note here, the flattened seventh there, and the fifth note here, which is why it sounds so good. And so that's it.